Let's talk to the man who wants to ask FM advertisers to think again. He's Maryland's Attorney General, Douglas Gansler, who cares deeply about this issue. His office received a complaint from a parent whose child had a bad experience with Ask FM. Mr. Attorney General, where does the responsibility here lie? And who can really put the pressure?
Well, the responsibility lies in a number of places. I think just in the interview you just had, one of them is education. I mean, having parents educate their children as to what a website like Ask FM is and what it is not, and to make sure that the reaction from the child is not overblown or to
right.
a place where they will actually commit themselves. But for Ask FM, obviously it's with the guys that are running the website. And the problem there is that they have no social consciousness. They're fully aware that children as young as 8 years old are on these websites. They know there have been multiple people that have taken their own lives just from Ask FM, and there are other sites like it, Ask FM being one of the most egregious. But then what we've been asking people to do is say, look, the only way these websites can actually function is if they're funded. And the way the people who are funding it are advertisers. Most legitimate companies, once we notified them that they were actually advertising on XFM, have taken their advertisements
right.
off of
this,
XFM.
This is the idea that you go for the pocketbook. And indeed, CNN spoke to Hubzu, a real estate website whose banner appears on Ask FM. They say, we have controls in place to prevent our banners from showing up on inappropriate sites. Our ad should never have appeared on this site, and we are investigating the issue with our network partners. So, Mr. Attorney General, just as with Facebook and Twitter and all these other things, go for the pocket.
Go for the pocket. That's what we did. There was a website called Juicy Campus, which was the same type of insidious, anonymous cyberbullying that was going on college campuses in the United States. And then there was something called peoplesdirt.com, same thing, but in high schools in the United States. And what we did there was we went to the internet provider, which were American registered companies, and said, you know, you have a contract with these advertisers. There's a violation of the contract because it says this is a website appropriate for as an educational bulletin board for young children. Well, clearly that's not what this is. The problem is most advertisers don't go directly to the website. They use brokers, and the brokers then are putting all these, picking the sites and the providers and sort of scattering them.
In the great scheme of issues that comes across your desk as Attorney General of Maryland, from consumer protection to crime to antitrust to all the issues you deal with, this internet trolling, this sort of abuse, where do you put it?
Well, I put it high because I have children. I think anybody who has children and understands that we live in this cyberbullying world puts it very high. I was actually the president of all 50 of the attorneys general in the country, and this was our issue, privacy and the internet. And we've worked with Facebook, we've worked with Twitter, we've worked with responsible companies in the United States to try and pull this type of insidious material off of the internet. It's not protected by First Amendment because it's being directed
right.
to children. And they're actually violating American laws by collecting information from young people as well.
Truth is, though, until you lock somebody up, nothing much will happen. I mean, yes, you can go for the economic effect, sir, but ultimately the sound of the jail door behind somebody, that'll soon sort it out.
It would, but the problem is the kind of conduct that's going on. Most of this cyberbullying is not of a threatening nature or of a criminal nature. It's just dumb people doing really insidious, egregious things that are actually resulting in people taking their lives, or the thousands and thousands of other children who stop short of killing themselves but have to live with this cyberbullying every day.
Douglas Gansler, Attorney General of Maryland, thank you, sir, for joining us. Good to talk to you.
My pleasure.